pleasure to meet you. I understand that you are here because you wish to become an official member of the all-exclusive, prestigious, and world-renowned International League of Intellectuals. Is that correct? Okay, great. Understand that you also would like to view and be able to watch the ASMR for intellectuals, but unfortunately you are unable to do so because you currently aren't a member of the I.L.I. Okay. Well, with a moment of your time, about an hour, I will be conducting the official I.L.I. application where I'll be asking you several questions to determine your eligibility and whether or not you are truly an intellectual, okay? Do you have the time now to dedicate to taking the application? Okay, great. Now, before we get started, let me go over a couple of the benefits that you will receive for becoming an official member of the I.L.I. First and most important, your very own I.L.I. membership card. So once this application process is complete, I will be reviewing your answers, and then I'll make the determination at the end of this. We'll see whether or not you will become a member, and if so, I will write your name on the official membership card, okay? You can see right there it says I.L.I., International League of Intellectuals, official member. Listen to the quality of that. We use the finest in membership cards. Okay. And on the back, it says, the bearer of this card is an official member of the prestigious and all-exclusive International League of Intellectuals and is granted the highest esteem and honor in society. So, not only will you be able to show all of your family members, your friends, and your colleagues that you will be, that you are a member, should you pass the test of the I.L.I., but whenever, say, you get pulled over by the police for speeding, or the FBI knocks on your door, you just show them this card, and they'll probably apologize for the inconvenience and let you go on your merry way, okay? You'll also probably receive some discounts, 5%, 10% off your next video game purchase, or your movie ticket, etc., book purchases. This is recognized in all major retailers across the globe, okay? So, that's the first thing. And let me show you some of the other goodies that you will get. Your very own hand-painted I.L.I. plaque. Just listen to this. Spare no expense when it comes to our you'll be receiving that. Of course, you will also receive your officially sanctioned I.L.I. hand grenade. Very useful in the case of emergency, or you come across any pseudo-intellectuals that are looking to cause mayhem and disrupt modern society. So, it's very useful. Or maybe you're going fishing and you don't have a fishing pole with you. So this hand grenade will come in very useful. No intellectual should be without one. Next, your very own officially sanctioned I.L.I. banana. Very important, very useful. Just carry it with you. Any intellectual worth their salt, always carry their I.L.I. banana with them. In the case of emergency, you might come across someone who's hungry, or you yourself might need to eat. So, okay. You'll receive that as well. Your officially sanctioned I.L.I. brown shoe. Intellectual should be without a shoe, as I'm sure you are aware of. I'm not sure if you've read up or studied beforehand on this application test you're about to take. It is the most difficult exam that you will ever take. Difficult than a bar exam, SAT. Okay. So you will receive your very own brown shoe. Next, one officially sanctioned I.L.I. mug. Not sure if I'm forgetting anything else, but I think you get the idea. So, officially sanctioned. If you ever see anyone drinking out of a mug that is not an I.L.I. mug, and they claim to be an intellectual, be wary of that individual, okay? Your own officially sanctioned I.L.I. cheese grater. As you know, intellectuals love their cheese. Cheeses, I should say. slices of cheese in the middle there. At the bottom, fine, really fine cuts of grated cheese. And some grated cheese, a little thicker, using the top slots there, so. Made from the finest metal and plastic. Okay. Your very own officially sanctioned I.L.I. potato. Very useful for many occasions. Maybe you want to start your own potato farm. Again, like the I.L.I. banana, this could come in very handy in case you come across anyone who is starving, especially if it's another I.L.I. member. Sanctioned I.L.I. wasabi peas. Again, somewhat similar use, like the banana and potato, but with wasabi peas, you can feed a lot of hungry people. Share them with your I.L.I. co-workers, family, friends, neighbors, or even offer them to some pseudo-intellectuals. Might help them boost their IQ so they can join the ranks of their intellectual brothers and sisters. Sanctioned I.L.I. moleskin notebook. No intellectual should go without a notebook to write down all their thoughts, analyses, and observations, as I'm sure you know. Answers to some of the greatest paradoxes. almost done here. But, as you know, us intellectuals are very generous. Your very own officially sanctioned I.L.I. cutting mat. Just listen to this. I'm not sure if you ever heard of an individual by the name of Professor Clemens. Runs in a hospital, I believe. I'm not really sure. Was once a member of the I.L.I., but then began to engage in some very questionable activities, and so we had to bar him from the I.L.I. Last but not least, officially sanctioned I.L.I. duct tape. Okay. Well, without any further ado, let's get started with the exam. I'll be asking some basic information first, and then we'll get started with the official application questions. May I have your name, please? Okay. What are the GPS coordinates of your current place of residence? Okay. Do you have an emergency contact, name and phone number, in the event something should happen to you during one of our meetings or conferences? Okay, go ahead. What is your blood type? Again, it's just for emergency information. Listed as an organ donor on your driver's license, or if you don't drive yet, in the event of a tragic accident, would you like to have your organs donated to science? Okay. Are you an active member of any other league, society, organization, group, sect, cult, government agency, gym, club, union, or after-school program? And if so, what are their names? Okay. The Tinfoil Hat Society. Oh, that's great. Tinfoil Hat Society. There are quite a lot of I.L.I. members who are also members of the TFHS. Anything else? You're part of a cult that doesn't yet have a cult name. Okay. They're just in the beginning stages. Okay. I'll just put down here the cult with no name. Anything else? Any other club, group, etc.? Okay. Is that it? Okay. Are your parents intellectuals, and are they members of the I.L.I? Okay. Are any of your siblings, if you have any, intellectuals and members of the I.L.I? Okay. Any of your friends, intellectuals, and members of the I.L.I. All right. Are any of your co-workers, intellectuals, and members of the I.L.I.? Said, please spell the word intellectual. I'll give you a moment to think about it. This is a very important, one of the most important questions of this application process. Are you ready? Okay, go ahead. Thank you. pairs of spectacles do you own? Okay. How many pairs of shoes do you own? Okay. How many comic books do you own? Whether it's floppies and or digital. Okay. How many action figures do you own? All right. How many video games have you played so far in your entire life? Okay. How many films have you watched so far in your entire life? Okay. How many intellectually stimulating videos do you watch every day on YouTube? Okay. How many times have you read the encyclopedia? Okay. And which chapter of the encyclopedia is your favorite? Okay. How many dictionaries and thesauruses do you own? Okay. How many times have you read the dictionary? Which chapter of the dictionary is your favorite? Okay. Name five of your favorite words from the dictionary. Okay. How many musical instruments have you mastered playing? Okay. Which of the following cheeses is most preferred by intellectuals? Cottage cheese, cheese whiz, cheese cake, cheese and macaroni, or cheese steak. Okay. Do you know how to ride a bicycle? Okay. Do you know how to change a flat tire, whether it's a bicycle, a tricycle, a unicycle, a car, a plane, a tank, a boat, etc. And do you know how to swim? Okay, just a moment. I'm going to change the paper here and put in the next set of questions. Is a tomato or tomato, however you want to say it. You say tomato, I say tomato. you say tomato, I say tomato. Or maybe we both say tomato, and someone else says tomato. Or maybe someone else says tomato, you say tomato, I say tomato, another group of people says tomato. Is a tomato or a tomato a vegetable or a fruit? Okay. And do you own a typewriter? Which of the following is one of the great intellectuals of all time? Homer Simpson, Porky Pig, Mount Kilimanjaro, Dutch Vanderland, Ronald McDonald. Someone lying in the road. They have been seriously injured and are begging you for help. What do you do? Rob them blind? Dial the emergency number, such as 911 in the US, and report it to the authorities. Then continue on your way, as you don't want to be late to the monthly I.L.I. meeting. Ask to see their I.L.I. membership card before doing anything. Sit down beside them and engage in an intellectually stimulating conversation about pain, life choices, death, and the probability of this current situation being different in an alternate universe due to the nature of quantum mechanics. Or take out your officially sanctioned I.L.I. med kit and immediately tend to their wounds once they have been patched up and stabilized. Should they offer to pay you in return, politely refuse and tell them it's what any intellectual worth their salt would do to help their fellow man or woman. So which of those choices would you do in that situation? Okay. Is the glass half full or half empty? Okay. Is the meaning of life to crush your enemies, see them driven before you, and hear the lamentation of their women? To master the fine art of origami? Aunt Millie's cat named Joe? Or to spread the good word of intellectualism all across the globe? What will your answer be? How many magic tricks can you perform? Okay. In your own words, explain the hidden meaning behind Dr. Seuss's green eggs and ham. Thank you. Which of the following is an intellectually stimulating activity? Caulking a tub, doing the laundry, ordering through the drive-thru, sleeping in on the weekend, spending 45 minutes customizing the appearance of a video game character. Okay. Okay, just a moment while I load up the next set of questions. This will be the last and final series of questions. Is an intellectual word. Soup. Loafers. Pseudo-intellectual. Nefarious. Intellectual. Okay. Why do words have multiple meanings? Okay. True or false? Schrodinger's cat is still alive inside the box. Okay. If a tree fell in the forest and no one was around, would the other trees hold a moonlit vigil as they lament and grieve over the loss of their fallen friend, while they share anecdotes and stories about how their fallen friend impacted each of their lives, while they shed tears made of sap? think Wile E. Coyote obsesses over catching the Roadrunner. Society by intellectuals: keychains, crayons, socks, toilet paper, sports. Society once you become an official member, or I should say, should you become an official member of the International League of Intellectuals. Okay. That's impressive. Okay, that concludes the exam. Just allow me a moment to review your answers. Next series of answers here. So far, so good. Okay. Looking good. Let's see if you got that question right. Okay. Just look at all the numbers that you gave me in regards to the number of films you've watched. member of the I.L.I. Just a moment. It's a momentous occasion. I'm going to write your name on the membership card. Let's make it official. I'm going to use this officially sanctioned this up here. Officially sanctioned I.L.I. rubber chicken. It's somewhat plastic, not floppy type of rubber, but you can prank and have some fun with your fellow I.L.I. members or family members, colleagues, with this rubber chicken. So here you go. I.L.I. model. cheese grater. There you go. I.L.I banana. Can have that. Now, which do you like to choose? Number 2 pencil, the Dixon Oriole, or the America's Pencil, USA Gold. America's Pencil. Wise decision. Wise choice. Okay, I'll put that there for you. Don't forget your officially sanctioned I.L.I. Wasabi Peas, courtesy of the Snack Man. Put that right there for you. Officially sanctioned I.L.I. brown shoe. Okay. Put that right here for you. And if you're unable to take all of this with you right now, I'll leave it here for you. You can come back. Sanctioned I.L.I. plaque. You can proudly display this on your desk, on your wall, wherever you like. Let everyone know you're an official member. Something very momentous and proud. Okay, well, congratulations again. Welcome to the I.L.I. And if you'll excuse me, I have some other exams conduct for some other folks who are looking to join the I.L.I. Hope to see you around. Take care and have fun being an intellectual.